As you can see behind my table is my reveal wall. I sell all of my images already printed and finished. You give me one camera with a good lens and you give me one girl, then I could make $3,000 a day. I've spent my life mastering my craft and I want to honor it by making beautiful portraits that are worth being paid, and you're worth being paid. Hi everyone, I'm Sue Bryce and today you're here in my LA studio and I would love to talk to you about marketing. So something that's gotten very confused in the years that I have been teaching is that I only photograph women. And one of the most interesting things is how that came about. So I was taught originally, my first boss was a man and he shot 80s glamour. So as our studio started to modernize into the 90s, we let go of 80s glamour because it was a dead genre. And we started shooting families, kids, and weddings. In fact, we had always shot weddings, but we really were called headshots and we moved towards Photographers Incorporated. We started to evolve into more of a lifestyle and family style of photography studio because we found that glamour photography in the 80s was completely dead. The problem was, as I was 22 years old and all I wanted to shoot was beauty. So I got very confused for a few years and I tried to transition into being a fashion photographer. I found two things happened. One was I really could not let go of glamour photography. The idea that a woman could come in, get her hair and makeup done, have gorgeous, glamorous portraits that were very outside of her everyday life and to see herself this way was what I truly loved about photography. And the other one was that I didn't like shooting families and babies. It really wasn't my thing. So I was kind of stuck in this halfway point. I then started to do fashion photography and I couldn't make any money, not anywhere near what I was making as a portrait photographer. So I keep going back to portraits. I made a deal with my boss in the very early 90s that if I could keep a makeup artist on staff, but also train her to be our receptionist who would answer the phone and do a lot of the processing of images when they came back from the lab, then I could keep a makeup artist on staff. And so what I started to do was transition a more modern idea of what 80s glamour was into a more fashion style, natural light, modern version. Now, at the time, I was in my mid-20s and I was watching this evolution of women shopping and how women shopped and beauty products and how beauty products were marketed to. And I started to market my portrait business as if I was a beauty product instead of a portrait studio. And I was really taken with this billion dollar industry, the multi-billion-dollar beauty industry that was marketing to me as a young woman. So I was like, well, surely I should market to these women in exactly the same way because it works. As I progressed, I started to read marketing books that were very focused towards what was called she marketing. The way you market to women is different than the way you market to men. Now, at this time, I'd been in a portrait studio for close to 12 years. I realized that the woman that was calling to book the photo shoot were always, in fact, women. 1% of the time, it would be a man on the phone. 99% of the time, I'm talking to ladies. When girls get pregnant, I would book the maternity shoot with the woman. When a woman got married, it was always the bride that was calling. When mum would call to book the family shoot, it was mum, not dad. When there was a newborn, a boudoir shoot, a senior, a graduation, a sweet 16, a 21st birthday, it was always ladies, 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 ladies. Now, that didn't mean that we didn't shoot dads. It didn't mean that we didn't shoot men for corporate looks. It didn't mean that we didn't shoot boys, sons, and sons and their mums. And it certainly didn't mean that we didn't shoot grooms because we certainly shot every single one of those men. But it was the girls that were making the booking. So I started to focus my marketing towards women. Now, any photographer, female or male, regardless of how old you are right now, you need to know your marketing demographic. There are four female shopping demographics. Let me take you through them. The first is girl power. She's 17 to 30. She's single, unmarried, and mostly this generation are living at home, which means she's tied to another female demographic, which is another shopping demographic, and that is the 50 plus female, which is her mum. So if I booked a mother and daughter shoot, and then I got dad and the other brother to come, then technically I'm doing a family portrait, but I'm marketing it to the women as a double makeover, girls' day out, mother and daughter shoot, and then the women are bringing the men. Now, if a girl power demographic brings in a 50 plus demographic, I double my sale. If I can get them to bring in dad, I triple it. And so my philosophy was, my market is women, but that doesn't mean I just shoot women. I need you to look at your demographics as being beauty products. What do these beauty products need? What are these demographics of these beauty products need? What are these demographics need, and what are they most drawn to? And that is life event. So 17 is going to book their senior graduation. They're going to book their 21st birthday. They're going to book their engagement shoot. They're going to book the girls' day out. They're going to book the mother and daughter shoot. The next demographic is independent woman. So that is a woman 30 to 50, unmarried. That is a powerful demographic. She's the highest earner of all the demographics. She's also the biggest spender of all four demographics. She has the most amount of debt. She probably has a mortgage. She's unmarried, so that doesn't mean she's not in a relationship or living with someone, and she has no children. So the majority of her income is being spent on her. She's the biggest spender, biggest balancer, and biggest spender of large ticket items, and she does not buy large ticket items without consulting at least two girlfriends. So she comes in sets of threes. So if you're doing girls' day out, beautiful women's portraits, couples, you know, corporate, powerful, powerhouse, independent woman, that is the market that you're attracting. Now, exactly the same age group, 17 to 50, you get the family first. Now, she's married with children, or she just has children. The truth is when you have children, you go to the bottom of the shopping list. So first off are the kids, second maybe the husband, the house, and then mum is last. So we know with the family first demographic that the second we are marketing to women with children, she's going to spend money on the kids first, which is why it's easy to market to this woman, because she's going to spend money on her kids. But she's going to spend more money if you get her in the photo shoot, and she's going to spend three times the money if you get dad in the photo shoot. That's just simple science. So the truth is these three demographics are really significantly based on how women truly shop around the world. We've got girl power, independent women, different demographics. We've got family first, totally different demographic. The most unmarketed to demographic in the world is 50 and fabulous, 50 plus. This demographic is not only the most unmarketed to demographic, we do not see this woman in our contemporary media. She doesn't exist unless she's selling hemorrhoid cream or maybe a retirement village. And yet the 50 and fabulous woman is extraordinary. She's inheriting from both her husband and her parents. She has actually controlling the world's wealth right now. If you take all of the women 50 plus in that demographic, they are spending more money on luxury lingerie and luxury travel than any other demographic in the world. They have money to burn, and we as photographers are not marketing to this demographic. We don't see them in our mainstream media. And this is crazy to me. She's the mother of the bride, so she's paying for the wedding. She is the mother, the grandmother, that will pay for the three generation shoots, $6,000-$7,000 without thinking twice about it. She's beautiful, she's fierce, she's proud, she's independent, she owns her own space, and she wants to be photographed. She just is not seeing herself in modern media. If you gave me the opportunity to start a business based on only one shopping demographic, I would not think twice about it. This girl is my future. She is the person I would photograph over any other demographic. And the irony is, she brings all the other demographics with her including the boys. She is the matriarch of the family, and she is the reason that we create portraits, and she has money to burn. My advice to any photographer is speak to this demographic. She is extraordinary, and she deserves to be marketed to. So why do I market to women? Because men don't spend money on portraits unless the girls bring them in. So I know my market. Now, is my genre contemporary portrait? Yes. Are my clients mostly female? Yes, because they spend the most amount of money. Just the same way the makeup industry makes billions a year, just the way Hallmark cards make billions a year, the way Valentine's Day markets to women, not men. Because we all know that men buy on Valentine's Day to please the woman in their lives. The truth is women are our market. Now, if you're a male photographer, you should know this. If you're a female photographer, you should know this, because all of us are marketing to the same gender-based marketing. But this is not a gender-based market. Okay, portrait photography has always been a mixture of men and women. I empower both men and women photographers to have successful businesses. It's not what your gender is, it's the gender that you are marketing to the most. So that is something I explain a lot, and it's something that I have to explain a lot, because I find that people do get very confused about it, and it's something that I find really interesting. I also include hair and makeup into my photo shoot. I always have, and not because I'm a contemporary woman's portrait brand, but simply because most people love to watch celebrity and transformations and makeovers, whether it's houses or weight loss or anything. People love to watch photo shoots, and they love the celebrity style of hair and makeup. I include it because it's a novelty to market in my business. It has always worked really well to show people all around the world what it looks like to have your hair and makeup done and be photographed like a superstar. At the end of the day, the bottom line is I am a portrait photographer, not a glamour photographer. I call myself a portrait photographer. I create portraits. If you come to me and you're a tomboy and you have short hair and you don't want to wear jewelry and makeup, I would photograph you how you want to be photographed, not my idea of photography or my idea of glamour. I'm definitely a girly girl, and I love hair and makeup. But you don't have to love hair and makeup to create this brand. Some of the best fashion photographers in the world create beautiful portraits, and they don't care about hair and makeup themselves. They simply offer it as a modern fashion style product. It's something that our market identify with. It's something that they're very, very consumed with in our everyday media, and it's something that they love. That's how I developed this brand and why I developed this brand. However, if you wanted lifestyle photography, natural light, no makeup, no fancy hair, no fancy outfits, I'm still your girl, because I'm a portrait photographer. And even though I primarily market myself as a glamour photographer look, I also photograph families, and people still to this day ask me to shoot their weddings, their babies, and their entire legacy of life events, because once you become somebody's photographer, they love you and trust you, and they want you at all of those special events. So primarily, I'm in the business of portraits. I will bend to whatever my client wants, and I make the choice now in my business as a mature photographer to accept work because I want the work. Not because I have to do something that I don't want to do, but I decide based on the client, the experience I've had with them, how long I've had them as a client, and how long I want to keep them as a client. My job is to keep people for life. I have what's called lots of repeat offenders. I have women I've photographed every year for 7 years that keep flying to me no matter where I am in the world, that want to experience a photo shoot with me, so that they can have the same feeling year in, year out. That's what I would love, to have the same clients every year for the rest of their life.